Welcome back to Hour 2 of Spooky South Coast. I'm here with Lynn Marie. We're going to be doing readings. So, do we have callers on the line just yet? Okay. So, for everybody that's listening, and I apologize for my opening, but my microphone didn't work. To call into our show, because we'll be doing free readings right now, you can call in at 1-877-996-1420 or 508-996-0500. These will be mini tarot card readings.
One card.
And
do you want the caller to do anything in particular when they first come on? Like, do you just want like a name and whatever?
They can do whatever they
do
like.
Okay.
They can do whatever they like. It's on them.
I'm going to start singing songs.
You can do... No, you don't want me to do that.
So, how are we doing over there? Oh.
Ready?
Are you ready?
I guess I'm ready. Let's do it.
Caller one.
All right, caller one.
Hello?
You're on the air.
Oh, okay. I'd like to have a reading.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good. What's your first name?
Phyllis.
Phyllis, we're going to pull a tarot card for you. Phyllis, I feel like you got a lot going on. Okay. So you picked the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords is a card that indicates that you are ahead of a conflict, but not quite out of the conflict yet. And it usually has to do with family or friends, close relationships. And does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
And for some reason, I actually feel like you're getting ahead of the conflict, so I want you to have a little bit more confidence in yourself that you are actually doing better than you think you're doing.
Okay.
Any questions?
No. Is anybody trying to get through to me?
It's a male that's trying to get through to you.
Okay.
Is your mom still here, too?
No.
Your mom's passed. Is dad gone as well?
Yes.
Okay. And you have siblings?
Yes.
Okay. So just know that your family is around you. They're very much around you.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you very much. Yep. Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you?
Fine. I'd like a general reading, please.
Okay.
We like general readings.
Yes.
What's your first name?
Dixie.
Hi, Dixie. That's a great name.
Yeah.
Did you know? Somehow or another, I'm psychically feeling that might be a nickname, huh?
Yes, my father's.
Yeah. Yep. And is it your dad was really important to you? You were pretty close to him?
Very.
Yeah, he misses you too. And the card that came up was the King of Wands, which is actually very interesting. Your father's passed, correct?
Yes.
And so for whatever reason, you have been asking him for some help on a situation. Is that correct?
Yes.
And he just wants you to know that he is around.
Oh, wonderful.
And you're very right to be asking him for help, because don't tell anybody else in the family, but you really were the favorite. Also, can I tell you to take a little bit better care of yourself, too?
Sure.
For whatever reason, I feel like you're not getting a lot of rest, and you kind of need it right now.
Okay.
Make sense?
Fine. Yes. Okay.
All right, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
All right, caller three.
We like general readings. General readings
yes.
are good.
Yes. Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Hello?
Hello, how are you?
How are you ladies doing tonight?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you. My name is Danny.
Hi, Danny.
One second. Okay, now I can hear you.
Okay, how perfect.
Good.
Okay. Danny, do you have a lot of intuitive ability yourself?
A little bit, yes.
Yeah, have you been thinking about using that?
Yes.
And learning a little bit more about it?
That's actually exactly what I've been thinking about, yes.
And you just picked the Star card, which is basically about focusing on where you're supposed to be and focusing on what you're supposed to be looking towards. And also that some things in the past are best left in the past. Do you understand that?
Yes, and actually that makes too much sense.
So you really need to leave some things in the past and continue to move forward and have a little bit more faith in the fact that what you're feeling and what you're able to do is actually real.
Excellent. Thank you.
You're welcome. Good luck.
I needed to hear that. Thank you very much, and we will be in touch.
Sounds good.
You're awesome. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you. You ladies are awesome, and the guys, too. Thank you so much. You did a great show.
Thanks.
Thanks.
All right. Do we have another caller? Perfect.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
Hello. Okay.
Can you turn down your radio for us?
Good. How are you? Sure. I can turn the radio down.
Okay.
Hold on.
Thank you. My name.
Okay.
All it's right, down. Perfect. We can hear you now.
Can you take a nice deep breath for me? What's your first name?
Kathy.
Hi, Kathy. How are you?
Okay.
Okay. Kathy, I don't know why, but I feel like you're making me smile, and I don't even know why. Hold on.
I'm making you what?
Smile.
I can't hear you.
Smile.
I'm making you smile?
Yes. So
I'm glad I'm making you smile.
You picked the Ace of Wands. So the Ace of Wands is about communication, and it's about getting in kind of in clear communication. But this is actually being in clear communication with yourself. So okay. Basically what it's indicating is that have you been dreaming a lot?
No, not at all.
What you're worried about? Are you worried that you're not hearing from people?
Yes.
Okay. So this is about you clearing your own channel so that you can be able to hear people and get some. So I feel like you want messages. I feel like you want to be dreaming about some people that are past, correct?
Yes.
And you're feeling like somehow or another you're being blocked from that, or it's not happening
yes.
for you. Yeah. The only reason that's being blocked for you is almost like when you want something too much, it's like you're focusing on it too much. And I feel like in this particular case, there are people trying to get through to you, in particular, mm-hmm. some family members. I know that sounds kind of lame, but I feel like you have a couple, so I don't want to necessarily pick one over the other. But I think that the issue is more about the fact that you want to hear it so badly that it's almost like when you want something so much, you can't have it. And this is just about you sort of relaxing. Remember when you first started and I said, take a nice deep breath? I think that's just because you just feel kind of jumbled up and kind of like not relaxed enough to sort of let stuff come through. And I feel like that's what you need to do. So no TV, no reading before bed. Take a few minutes before you fall asleep and just ask your people to come through to you and you will get that.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you so
All
much
right.
for calling in.
All right, Thank you so
night.
Much.
You're welcome.
Hello, you're on Spooky South Coast.
Hello.
How are you?
Hi, Lynn.
Hi. How are you?
Good.
Good. What's your first name?
This is Ellen.
Hi, Ellen.
Hi, honey.
You just wrote to me on Facebook.
I found you.
You did. How are things? Good?
Good. 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 Good.
Ellen, why are you not taking care of yourself?
What do you mean, how come I'm not taking my care? I just went to the doctor's.
I know. You're physically okay, but what's going on with you? Are you still... why is your friend still trying to get in touch with you?
I don't know.
Well, he is.
He hasn't really.
Yeah, he's trying to, though. So, how are you doing otherwise? Everything okay? Husband okay?
Everything's good.
Good. Well, I'm glad to hear you, but you know your friend wants to get in touch with you, so I will talk to you at some point in time about that.
Well, we will, hopefully soon.
Yeah, but I'm glad you called.
Well, I figured it out.
Well, good. But I don't think your friend's message wants to be on the air, so that's why I'm saying I'll probably write to you on your Facebook post. So
we'll talk to you soon.
Okay.
Awesome. Thank you for calling.
Thanks, honey. Happy Memorial Day.
And to you as well.
Bye, sweetie. Bye-bye.
Bye, honey. That's nice. I love when people call in that know me. That's nice.
It is. It's good support, for sure. It's always awkward reading on the radio, so it's nice when you have
people
calling.
Well, it's funny because she wrote me on Facebook, and she's like, I can't find the broadcast. I can't find it, so I'm glad she found it. So
I have to admit, it's extremely difficult to sit here and push all these buttons and do everything while you're doing readings because I'm trying to totally not connect to anything that you're connecting to, but we already have the weird mind thing going on, so it's really hard to push myself away.
And I actually am kind of having a moment where I'm like, oh, man, a lot of people are picking cards that are hard. Like, these are hard things for them today, so let's see how this goes.
Right. Yeah. So we have no calls right now. We have a break. Nope. Perfect.
Yay.
Can you tweet out that we're doing readings?
Yes.
Okay. So,
do you want to pick
a card? I was going to say, do you? I know you were going to do this.
You're so, here, so shuffle.
You're going to read me live on the radio right now.
How are you feeling about that?
A little exposed. Huh? Okay. Well, we'll...
Should I do a call?
You want to do a call first?
Well, I'm shuffling.
She's shuffling.
She needs her cards. Yeah. And I just knocked the energy out. So, hold on. We'll let the cards build up. So that way we can give you a small break. All right.
What a break. I have to read yours.
I'm scared.
Don't be scared.
I'm terrified.
Oh, Miss Stephanie. You would pick the strength card.
Of course I would.
Of course you would. Uh-huh. And in your case, this actually isn't about physical strength. This is about the things that we were talking about earlier. This is about maintaining your integrity and your position and understanding that you are doing exactly what you're supposed to be doing.
Okay. Makes me feel a little better.
I know. I figured that was
We're going to need an elaboration later.
I know. Off when we're not on.
You can go home at 3 o'clock in the morning. How does that sound? All right. You ready for...
I don't know, the silent assassin should have picked a card, but...
I think so, too.
He's basically ignoring me at the moment.
What do we have for calls, Matt? Or how many we have?
Crazy.
Okay.
Locked and loaded.
Locked and loaded? You ready for rapid fire?
Let's do it.
Okay. Good evening, you're on Spooky South Coast. Hello?
Spirit called.
Yes. I like those. Those are interesting. Ready? Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Ellen, when are you going to stop smoking pot?
Hello? We can probably drop that one.
I'm not really clear.
Ellen, stop smoking pot.
Right. Damn you, Ellen.
Hello.
Hi, you're on the air.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello. Hi. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good.
Sounds like you guys are having fun over there.
Oh, well, we're trying.
That's great. Light energy. Good light energy.
Yes, we're trying for sure.
What's your first name?
Pam.
Oh, Pam. Let's see. Pam, you got the Seven of Swords. So... Uh-huh.
Yeah.
The Seven of Swords is a complicated card, and I think for you, it's actually a good news card. I think this is basically telling you that a lot of the things that you have been working on are coming to fruition. It's a good thing for you. You've been a little stuck, and it's time for you to move a little forward. So this is kind of about you moving forward and taking kind of reaping some benefits of some things that you've done for yourself.
Okay. Well, we'll see about that. But,
I know. It doesn't feel like it right now. That's why it's
No, it doesn't.
And that's why it's a swords card, because swords are tough. When you pick like wands or cups, they're usually more lighthearted. Swords are cards where it kind of indicates that things have been a struggle and not always been easy. And that you're kind of still in the middle of that. That's why it's a seven. But seven is a good luck number, and it's supposed to mean that at some point in time, things are going to turn.
It's my number as well.
And
lots of, as a matter of fact, I have to share this with you real quickly. Back in September last year, I was looking out of the window at the sky, and there was an actual seven in the sky in the shape of a cloud.
Wow, that's very powerful.
I like the picture of it. I have a picture of it on my phone.
Wow,
oh, yeah.
That's amazing. Well, you picked a seven, and I think that is supposed to mean it's a good card for you. But when I picked it, I was like, oh, she's not going to see this as a good card because it's a swords. But it does mean that, you know, you're kind of playing things a little bit closer to yourself and kind of trying to figure out your next moves and things. But you are being validated, and it's good to move that along.
Great. Thanks All so right. much.
Good luck.
Thank you.
It hasn't been easy.
Thank you for calling.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
What do we have next, Matt?
Spilled water. We have that.
Besides Lynn making a mess.
I didn't do that.
Did I do it?
Yes.
Oh, cool. I wanted to blame it on you.
You just wanted to blame it on
yeah,
me.
Yeah, that's perfect. Oh, look.
Oh, look
at how smart
towels.
He is.
Really, I just wanted to use that whole box of tissues.
Can't take me anywhere. Not at all. This is why I shouldn't host a show.
This is why you should not have two psychics in a room. Okay.
Matt, how much do you hate me right now? Oh, okay. We're good. We're good.
He's not feeling the hate.
No. This is good. I can do that.
This should be a call. Oh, are you a caller? Are we taking a call?
No.
What are we doing?
Ready?
Oh, yeah, ready.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Spirit called.
Hello?
Oh. Spirit was done.
Yeah. Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Hi. I was just calling in to try and get a reading.
Awesome.
What's your first name?
Jared.
Hi, Jared. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks. Jared, are you working?
Not right now. I'm at home.
Is it? No, I know. I didn't mean right at this moment.
Well, I work for an airline, so yeah.
Okay. So is that what you want to be doing?
Yeah. Right now, yeah.
Yeah. So you picked the King of Swords, which is a card that kind of indicates that you need, that you have a lot of strength of character and you have a lot of strength of personality. But that sometimes you get a little complacent with things. And this is indicating that it's time for you to start deciding if this is really where you want to be and how you want to get to your next level. But it's a really, really positive card, even though it's a sword. Swords tend to be a little bit about conflict and stuff like that. But in mm-hmm. this particular case, the King of Swords is about being sort of on top of your game. And I think that that is true for you. I do feel like you have a lot of ambition, and I do feel like you have a lot of desire about what you want to do, but just not always exactly have the direction straight, if that makes sense.
No, it does, because I've been through a lot over the last couple of years that have forced me to change directions and areas that I wanted to go, and now I'm forced to go different ways.
Yeah, and I think the thing is that no matter what you do, you kind of come out on top, which is a great quality to have, but I think that the struggle sometimes gets old for you. And
yeah, I would agree with that.
Yeah, but you're doing really well, and I think that's the thing that's really important is to remember is that the decisions that you're making really end up being the better decisions because you're in charge of them, not necessarily because they're always great decisions, but because you're in charge of them.
Yeah, because you've actually done readings for my mom, actually my family, a couple of times. You've come to the house, and every time I've been unable to make it. So when my mom, she just actually texted me and said, hey, call in. Maybe you can finally, you know, get a reading and chat with you about it. So.
Well, and I think you probably have some mediumship that you need to kind of touch base with, too. But I think that, you know, obviously on the few minutes on the radio probably isn't enough time. But I definitely feel that you are in charge of things, and I feel that's a good energy for you. You have a very positive energy. I think you just get a little waylaid sometimes. It doesn't always come out, but you're doing well.
Oh, good. I'm sure my mom's listening, and I'm sure she's very glad to hear that because she worries about me a lot.
Well, she shouldn't. You're doing okay.
So good. And I think actually you had said that to her in one of the sessions you had with her. So.
Well, it's good to know I'm consistent.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much for calling.
Right, bye-bye.
All right. Have a good night. Bye.
You too.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast with Lynn Marie.
Hello?
Stephanie. Hello.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
And your first name is?
Lisa.
How did I know that?
I don't know.
So here's the thing that kills me the most. You picked the world, which means that you are in pursuit of harmony and perfection. And both of those things are not necessarily within your grasp currently, but will become clear at some point in time. But not without a little bit more patience.
Any timeline?
It's funny that you say that, because the next card that I bet I was going to pull for you would have been definitely a timeline. And it is the Magician, so I would say by September.
Okay.
All right.
I can hold on till then, I think.
I think you'll be fine. You have a lot of support.
Yes, I do.
Thanks for calling.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast. Who are we speaking with?
Dawn.
Hi, Dawn.
Hi, Dawn. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. I feel like I want to pick a really special card for you, Dawn. I feel like you need it.
It's hard to hear you. I'm sorry. What was that?
I said, I really want to pick a special card for you. I feel like you need it.
Okay.
And I did. And you're probably not going to agree with me, but it is a really good card. I picked the devil. And I know, right? I knew you were going to be like, oh no, but the devil is actually a really good card. The devil is about listening to your base instinct and sort of being a little bit indulgent of yourself. And I have a funny impression, Dawn, that you don't always get to be very indulgent of yourself. So I feel like you are supposed to kind of indulge yourself in something that you want or that you want to do. Now, that doesn't mean I'm suggesting you go out and, you know, buy a $500 pocketbook or anything. But but I think that you should do something for yourself and something that makes yourself feel better and give back to yourself, because I feel like you give to a lot of other people.
I do.
I know. So it's time for you to do something for yourself.
Okay.
Okay, and I know that's going to be really hard for you, but try.
I will try.
Okay, and hang in there. Things are going to get a little bit easier for you, too.
Okay, great.
And your health is improving, correct?
It is, thank you, yes.
Okay, I'll continue to think good thoughts for you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you for calling. Good evening, you're on Spooky South Coast.
Hello.
Hello.
May I have a reading?
Absolutely.
May we have your name?
Maria.
Hi, Maria.
Hi.
Oh, Maria, you have so much grief.
Oh, my.
Oh, are you okay?
Yes.
I don't even know if I want to pick a card for you. This is a male that's for you?
I'm sorry?
Is there a male that's passed for you?
No, not that I know of.
Your dad isn't passed?
Yes.
Okay. And is your mom still here?
Yes.
How's she doing?
So.
Yeah. Are you the one that's taking care of her?
Yes.
Okay. And you're worried about her a lot?
A lot, yes.
Okay. So you know that it's not her time yet, right?
I don't know. You know, I'm hoping not.
It's not. She's gonna be around for a little bit longer. I don't want you to worry so much about that.
Good.
The card that you picked is the Eight of Swords, and the Eight of Swords is all about worry and stress, and it's outside stress and worry. So worried about other people, worried about other things. I feel like you, again, like the previous caller, do a lot for other people, but I also feel like you put a lot of worry and stress on yourself. And this card is reminding you that there are certain things in life that you cannot control, and that all you can do is the best you can do, which you do. And you just have to remember that, and it's hard. But I feel like your mom is a big concern for you, and I just wanted to let you know that she seems to be holding her own and doing okay for right now.
Good. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a good weekend.
Yes, thank you. Good night.
Thank you for calling us. Good evening, you're on Spooky South Coast. Who are we speaking with?
I don't know. Hope not.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Who are we speaking with?
You'd like to get a reading, please?
Yes. Your name?
Mitch, I'm a TCH.
Hi, Mitch. How are you?
I'm doing okay.
Good. So let's see what card we're going to pull for you. You're not nervous, are you, Mitch?
Nervous? Well, I never really called in for a reading before. I was encouraged by a friend of mine to do so.
Are you gonna yell at that friend? No.
Yeah, he's right beside me, so
I guess we won't. We'll yell at the friend for you.
And you're on speaker, so.
Awesome. Where are you calling from, Mitch?
Calling from South Florida, Fort Lauderdale.
Okay. Awesome. So I actually pulled three cards for you, because I feel like that was really important. So what's really interesting about your cards is they start off on one level and completely go to another. So there's some harmony. The World is a very good card. It basically means that everything sort of moves along at its own pace. And I think that that's been okay with you in the past, to kind of let things happen as they're supposed to happen. But that energy is ending, and you have to get a little bit more in control of your own life and where you kind of want it to go. I think that it goes all over all different aspects of your life, not just finances or work or relationships. I think it's kind of everywhere. You have a lot more authority over your life than you're sort of allowing yourself to believe or to think. So it's sort of telling you that you can make some changes that you want to make or do some things that you want to do and that they will be successful.
Okay.
That's basically what I'm feeling for you. And I also feel like you, you've just kind of had some, you know, you've kind of been sailing along and it's time for some things to move for you. And I think it's time for that to happen.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Good luck.
Thanks.
Thank you for calling. Good evening. You're
Hello?
On Spooky South Coast. Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
Can we have your
this
name?
Angel.
Angel?
I was fine awesome. Out of reading.
Hi, Angel. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. Angel, who's the female that's passed for you?
It would be my mother.
And is your mom, was your mom ill?
Yes.
And did you help take care of her?
Yes.
And you miss her a lot? You've been talking to her a lot?
Yes.
Okay. The card that got picked for you is the moon. The moon is a very interesting card, but for you in particular, it's all about female energy. So it's basically about how you've been thinking about your mom a lot and also just a lot of female strength in your family, like a lot of the female lines sort of being the strong people in your mm-hmm. in your life, including you. Yeah. And do you have children?
Yes.
And I feel like you have to be very strong for, do you have two?
Yes.
You have to be very strong for both of your children, but one in particular. Do you understand?
Yep.
And that you have been really worried and stressed out thinking that what you're supporting and what you're doing is not enough. But that is not the case. You are made of very strong stuff, so remember that. And your mom is with you, and she is helping you because she says that you've been asking her for that.
Your voice went down. I didn't hear that last part.
I said your mom's been knowing that you've been asking her for help, and just know that she's been around.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Good luck.
Thanks.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Hey. Can we have your name?
This is Scott.
Hi, Scott.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Pretty good. Pretty good.
Would you like a reading?
Sure.
That was so casual, Scott. Sure. Yeah, whatever. No
what I'm here for.
So, what an interesting card. We picked the Ace of Swords for you. The Ace of Swords is a need to be aggressive about a particular situation.
Okay.
And aggressive is not always necessarily a negative thing. Do you understand?
Yes.
Sometimes it's about just sort of, I guess the phrase that keeps coming to my head is taking the bull by the horns. And for whatever reason, I feel like you're comfortable in that role, but for some reason you haven't done it about a situation in your life that you kind of need to. And it's not a bad thing at all. If anything, it's probably going to be a release and a good thing for you.
That's good to know. That's pretty accurate.
Well, good. I try. Thanks for calling
in. Thank you for calling, Scott.
Thank you.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Good evening.
Could we have your name, please?
My name is Lois.
I already Lois. Knew that.
Of course you did.
Yes.
Oh, Lois. Well, I feel like a lot goes on with Lois. I feel like Lois has a lot going on.
Oh, you're right.
Yep, and you and your card reflects that. You picked an Eight of Swords, too. What's really interesting about the Eight of Swords for you is, unlike the previous caller that picked the Eight of Swords, for you, the Eight of Swords is more about having more than one area of your life being touched by things at the same time, like a lot of different focuses that need to happen for you, and that you are actually doing a good job at juggling and managing them, but are you feeling a little discouraged at the moment?
Yes, I am.
Okay. So this card is supposed to remind you that you actually are doing a better job than you think you are, but that it's hard because you have a lot going on. So you have to kind of remember that some things have to be done one at a time. Some things kind of have to be handled one thing at a time. Do you understand what I mean?
I do. It's all financial.
I know. And it's also, you know, some of the stuff you haven't had control over either. And I think that you're starting to gain a little bit more control and a little bit more perspective on it. But I think it's hard for you. So try not to be discouraged, because things are actually getting into a better situation, but just not necessarily flowing fast, if that makes sense.
Yes, that does make sense.
So try to sleep easy tonight, because I feel like your anxiety is keeping you from getting really good rest.
Oh, perhaps that's it.
But there's, you know, you can only do what you can do, so try to give yourself a break.
Okay, and thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay, take care.
Thanks for calling.
Okay, thanks. Bye.
Mom.
Is that your mom?
Yep. Yep.
Hi, Stephanie's mom.
I didn't want to give away anything ahead of time, but I know that voice anywhere, so.
But did that card make sense for you?
Yeah.
That's good.
Yep. All right, next caller. Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Hi.
Hi. Can we have your name, please?
Jess.
Jess?
Is that yes or Jess? I was like, what?
Yes.
Jess.
I was like, okay, yes, okay. How are you, Jess?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. How was your Mother's Day, Jess?
My mom?
How's your mother? How was your Mother's Day?
Mother's Day?
Yeah. Are you a mom?
Nope.
Do you have your mom still with you?
Yep.
And how's she doing?
Good.
Okay. Queen of Pentacles is a time frame card. This means that there are changes coming in your life that some of them you may want, some of them you may not want. None of them are negative. But change is coming, and this is a time frame card that indicates August, September, and October. So you sort of need to be prepared that some things are going to change for you come August, September, and October. But it's supposed to be a good thing, because it's a harvest time, so it's usually when you're reaping benefits. So it's a good thing. All right.
Okay.
Well, thank you for calling us, Jess.
Thanks for calling.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast. Can we have your name? Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Can we have your name?
This is Ed.
Hi, Ed. How are you?
All right.
Good. Ed, how are things going?
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, they could be a little bit better.
A lot, yeah.
Yeah. So you picked the King of Cups, which is an emotional card. So for you, this is a very masculine emotional card, which means that a lot of things in your life need to wash through. You need to sort of be a little bit patient with yourself and understand that there's only so much you can do about so many things. Things are scheduled to be a little bit more improved for you, but I think some things just need to be kind of, I don't know how else to put that. You just kind of need to hang in there. You know what I mean? Like, some stuff just isn't going to change as quickly as it should. But it will. And that's what it's a hopeful card. It's a card that gives you an indication that things need to actually kind of move quickly, but you don't have control over how fast that's going to be. So for you, you want everything to move yesterday and be different as of yesterday, and it might be tomorrow. Do you understand? So no matter what it is, it's not going to be fast enough for you, but it is coming. So you just need to kind of hang in there. It's just a little bit longer of a ride, and I know you've been on one already. So just be patient. It's coming.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you for calling.
Bye-bye.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast. Can we have your name? Hello.
Hello, ladies. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm fine. My name's Martina.
Hi, Martina. How are you?
I'm great.
Good. I'm glad to hear someone's great.
Oh, have to think positive, you know.
That's right. Where are you calling from?
From Dartmouth.
From Dartmouth? Okay.
Yes, Dartmouth, Mass.
Okay. Well, we like that. We like Dartmouth. Dartmouth is good.
Oh, good.
So, Martina, this is an interesting card for you. You picked the Lovers, and the Lovers is actually not about the Lovers.
That's a shame.
I know, right? But the Lovers is about having opportunity and having choices to make. Mm-hmm. And sometimes wondering whether or not those choices are the right way or the wrong way. Mm-hmm. And it's not really about handling a situation. It's more about things being presented to you. You know, certain things being presented, maybe not as a surprise even, you know, things that you weren't expecting and having to sort of make some choices. But they feel like good choices. They feel like positive choices, like things that might actually affect you in a good, positive way. And it's almost like manna from heaven, like something comes down that's unexpected. And that it's a good thing when it comes down. And you could use that. I think you could use a little of that.
So I'll be making good choices, what you're saying?
You'll be making good choices based on things that kind of fall into your lap. Yes.
Well, that'd be a welcome pleasure.
Amen. It would be a welcome change. All I can tell you about you, Martina, is you have earned it, my friend. So I hope that when that manna from heaven comes down, it's a good feeling because you've earned it. You've put the time in.
Yeah. Okay, great. Well, I'm glad you're picking up on that, too.
Thank you very much for calling.
Thank you.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast.
Hi.
Hi. Can we have your name?
Matthew.
Oh, I knew that, too. That voice, I know.
Hello, Matthew. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Why do I feel like Matthew talks? Matthew talks. All right. Let's see. You picked the Eight of Cups. So the Eight of Cups is an interesting card for you because I think it has a dual meaning. The Eight of Cups is sometimes about leaving some things behind that aren't serving you any longer and moving forward, and about gaining perspective on things that you need to gain perspective on. So sometimes it's about leaving something behind but knowing what you're gaining by doing that. And sometimes it's about understanding that you can't always move forward until you're able to leave something behind. Make sense?
Absolutely.
And that is exactly where you are. And the funny thing is that you know it, but it's kind of like a choice and a decision, and it's not always easy to make that. So, but I think you'll do fine.
Fingers crossed, right?
Amen.
Well, thanks for calling.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Everybody's so like quiet that they're like, bye.
That was my brother.
Oh my goodness.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast. Can we have your name?
Hi, it's John.
Hi, John. How are you?
Good, thanks.
Good. All right, hang on. Sorry, I had to shuffle. They hadn't been shuffled in a few. Let's see. Ace of Pentacles. This is worries about work. Worries about work, worries about money, and worries about happiness, but not necessarily all in that order. So this is kind of all about having anxieties and worries, but not necessarily acknowledging that they're anxieties, more like worries and burdens. Some things are beyond your control, but some things are coming your way that need to change, but you're kind of dependent on other people to have those things changed. I don't know how else to explain that to you, and a lot of that feels like work. Like you almost have to wait on other people to move around or do things in order for you to be able to move around and do things. So this is about things gaining, and also worries that you have about family members' health seem to be unfounded, like things are actually going to go well.
Okay.
And
can you say that again?
With the whole thing or just the last part?
No, I missed the last sentence.
I just said worries about family members' health that feel unfounded, like things are actually going to go better than expected.
Fantastic. Do you see my career moving forward with the promotion?
Well, I think that the Ace of Pentacles is exactly like that. I said you have to kind of wait on other people. So it's almost like you have to wait on other situations to clear, but it does look like it will happen.
Fantastic.
All right.
Great. Thank you for the reading.
All right, you're welcome. Have a good night.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Good evening. You're on Spooky South Coast. Can we have your name?
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Thank you. My name is Crystal.
Hi, Crystal.
Hello. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Excellent. Thank you.
Good. Crystal, I feel like you have changed a lot of things in your life for the positive, and I just wanted to kind of commend you for that. I think that hasn't always been an easy thing for you to do. So I just want to tell you that that comes across for whatever reason, if that makes you, understand that.
Thank you.
And the Ten of Pentacles is about needing to be focused a little bit on your own personal financial security. That you sort of need to be working towards a goal. And it's not all about money. Sometimes it's just about a goal and working towards it. And again, I think that you have done a very good job about changing around some things and changing around your mentality on a lot of things. But I think that you need to be told that that work is good, that you have done good work with that. The Ten of Pentacles is about seeing the results of some of that. And that's coming your way probably within the next 3 to 4 months.
Okay.
So it's great. Good. It's a positive thing. I'm glad to know that you're looking out for yourself. I know you have other people to worry about, but for some reason I want you to remember that you've done some good work for yourself too.
Great. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Have a good night.
Thank you too.
Thank you for calling.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye. Good evening. Can we have your name?
Jay.
What?
Jay.
Jay?
That's your name?
Yeah, that's my nickname.
Okay, perfect.
How are you, Jay?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you feeling?
I'm not bad.
Yeah, are you better?
Well, my back's a little better.
Well, that's good. So the Five of Wands is what got picked for you. And the Five of Wands is about sort of remembering to communicate what's necessary for you. That this is about not necessarily soft soaping or sugar coating things for yourself. If you need help, you need to ask for it. If you need direction, you need to ask for it and not be ashamed to do that. Do you understand?
I understand.
And you need to take a little bit better care of yourself communicatively. In other words, like I said, if you need help or if you need something, you need to make sure that you express it and not just try to be strong and suck it up, do you know? That's
you mean health-wise?
Health-wise, not necessarily. I feel that emotionally. I feel it more health-wise. You need to be your best advocate.
I see.
And it's not always easy for you. I think that you like to be independent and you like things to go, you know, well for you. And I appreciate that. But I think that you have to remember to ask for help when you need it.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. Things are gonna even out a little bit, but you got to remember that it's okay to accept some help once in a while.
Well, thank you. I will.
All right. You
thank
take
you.
Care.
Thank you. Good night.
Night.
Good night.
That's it for calls right now.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Ooh, that was like a good string.
Do you know our total?
I lost track, actually.
Did you?
Yeah. I was going to look at the caller ID later. I think about 80. Give or take.
It was a lot. We had some good calls.
We can always go back and count them. So we have an official count.
It's all good. So, yeah, the cards have been really interesting tonight.
Definitely. We have about 5-ish minutes left if any last-minute callers want to sneak in.
So doing all these power readings, does this actually drain just everything out of you?
Yeah. Can you tell?
Yes.
So what's a good recharge for a psychic medium? Is it just sleep, or
food
do you just take a bath in crystals? I don't know. What do you guys do?
Do we bathe in crystals?
I feel
do
like your house
that?
Is just
no,
filled
but I know
crystals.
People that want to. Does like, that count?
You just open up doors and cabinets. You're like, who put all these crystals here?
I actually have very few crystals in my house. Actually, I have some selenite and some amethyst, and that's about it. I can't wear fluorite because then I tell the truth even worse. It's crazy. but I don't know what's good for I can't answer for Stephanie, but for me, usually when I read, I have to literally eat and sleep in that order.
Well, I know how Stephanie recharges.
Yeah.
Big Bang Theory.
Big Bang Theory?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Put that on.
I thought you were going somewhere else with that for a second then.
Nope,
I know. I was like,
don't tell all of my secrets on the radio. Jeez.
Usually eat and sleep. And I have to say that I read roughly anywhere from 80 to 100 people a week. So this is the end of my week. I usually take Sundays off. So I work today. this is more work. I worked last night. I worked the night before. So it is. It can be very draining, but I actually really enjoy it. And Stephanie's a battery for me. So having her here kind of gives me a little bit of an edge.
Oh, like a power cell.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It's like she's like my second battery there. She's good.
Pizza or cheeseburgers is a go-to.
Yeah, absolutely. For me. Greasy food. Greasy really food. Works. Yeah.
You know what? I actually read that.
It's similar to like a hangover.
Kind of. Yeah,
kind of, for sure. Yeah.
I mean, there are times when people will call me in the morning and I'm like, oh, I have a spirit hangover. And they totally get it. Right. They're like, yeah.
People come up to me at events and be like, how are you putting down that much food? I'm like, don't ask questions. Just keep walking.
Just keep nothing going. To see here.
I read the Hollywood Medium, Tyler Henry, did an interview the other day. And somebody asked him how he keeps going. And he said, tons of carbs. Pizza, greasy pizza, everything. I was like, yes, it's not just me.
Yeah, no, it's not. And for whatever reason, I feel like breakfast, diner, greasy diner, spoot food is like the best for whatever reason. So not sure why.
I don't know. I don't know what it is, but I've heard it from a lot of people. So it's a mystery to be solved at some point, for sure. Yeah. Definitely.
I love being on here. Can I tell you that?
Well, we love having you. It's amazing to have you all the time. Yeah, just come in all the time. Don't move far away ever. Yeah, nope, sorry.
No, I'll be, you know, I can never stay away from you, Stephanie. You're my sister.
You can't, I know. It's just too much fun, and apparently you're the only one that ever makes me snort on live radio, so thank you.
I thought that was awesome, personally. Yep. And I just want to, you know, thank your mother and brother for calling I had no idea. The only person I kind of want to address one thing to is Ellen.
Okay.
And she called earlier. I just feel like your friend just wanted you to know that he was okay. But I just feel like he didn't want to make a big fuss. He wanted it to be sort of about him.
Which is okay.
Yeah. So I just kind of wanted to mention that.
Well,
so
we are coming to the end of our show.
Oh,
we
have about that was so quick.
How long do we have, Matt? A minute? Ish.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell everybody where they can reach you, how they can get a private reading with you, where you'll be?
Sure. I have several offices, so you can see me in Bridgewater, West Bridgewater, Amherst, Dedham. And of course, now I'm going to be stretching myself out down to your area.
You are.
I am. So you can reach me at 508-474-9371. You can email me at Lynn with an E, MarieSpiritMedium@gmail.com, which is all one word, LynnMarieSpiritMedium@gmail.com. Or you can catch me on Facebook, Spirit Medium Lynn Marie. You can also see me on TarotByLynnMarie.com. So anywhere that you can reach me, you should reach me.
Absolutely. And yeah. It's 100% worth it, I swear. I considered saying stay live on YouTube after... so everybody can see my reading, but I'm a little afraid for that, so we might have to write a blog about it afterwards, because I don't know if I want those details out there. So thank you so much for everybody for tuning in this week. Like I said before, Tim and I are going to be at a bunch of different places coming up. Middleboro Paracon, Ocean State Paracon, Ghost of the Gateway. Definitely go to SpookySouthCoast.com and check out and see what we have going on. Like us on Facebook, we have all of our updates there. Our silent assassin is amazing at putting out clips and week in weird stories.
Love
all week
you, Matt.
Long. I know, he's amazing. So definitely reach us any way you can. You can find me on Twitter and everywhere else at Work at Burke. So thank you so much for listening in and putting up with me hosting the show. You are all amazing, and we will be back next week for sure. So stay spooktacular.
Thanks, everybody.